So recording here, the critical path on D3D, we just stated that we're working off Prusa i3 as one of the best, if not the best, 3D printers that are open source, and we're developing D3D, which is OSC's scalable, modular, focus on scalability version of a higher quality machine that can be used to make much bigger parts as well, up to like a meter or two in size. We decided that we'll run with the Prusa i3 and develop D3D at the same time. Within the scope of the thesis of Torbjorn, we will go with the Prusa initially, and as soon as we have the D3D that's workshoppable, that means it's good enough to be produced in a workshop, then we will switch to that. So the
that's just because the Prusa is the state-of-the-art workshop printer right now, so we should really compare to that.
Yeah, okay. Is anyone running the Prusa workshops right now?
Sure. I'm sure people run Prusa workshops because they're everywhere.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But I don't know any...
Okay.
People does that right now.
Yeah. Sorry, you said you don't know any specific people who are running that right now, and it might be worthwhile to find out. So we'll rope in. I just talked briefly to Alec about this, and I'm waiting for Joshua to respond. But on Alec's side, what I was going to have him do is basically take the Prusa kit, we can start the sourcing for that, and I will have Alec create a library set within FreeCAD. So pulling down all the parts off manufacturers, Misumi, or wherever, putting in all the individual parts, and making sure we can source them. So basically do the sourcing and part verification for the kit to see what it would cost to do a kit that's sourced by ourselves versus a ready-made kit that we can get from some other place. So that would be the idea. So, but as far as right now for the Prusa kits, let's see, we need a list. Did you write down the kit sources somewhere?
That was for the Prusa steel.
Oh, steel. Okay, forget about that one, since that one is not open source by Ashwa standards. So, I also noticed that Prusa says about the, on his website about the i3, he says, uses 100% open source parts. Well,
okay.
I think that's not true if the E3D nozzle is being used. So maybe that was for the older versions, but I just noticed that might need updating. Should ask him about that. So let's look at Prusa i3 kits. Where do we find the list of those?
I'm looking right now on the RepRap site.
Prusa i3 Buyer's Guide. And the Prusa i3 requires some 3D printing of parts, right, for itself?
Yeah.
Okay, so there's a big list of full kits on the Prusa i3 Buyer's Guide. That's what we're looking at? Okay, so let's document that. I think we can just go... I mean, if this is D3D development, we can set up a new page that's called Prusa i3 development or workshop.
Yeah.
Let's just call it Prusa i3 for iteration 3.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So I just started that page on the wiki. Mm-hmm.
We see the list of workshops on the RepRap wiki.
Okay, let me look at that. Wow, this is so good that it's, all that work is already done for us. And that's really good. So let's see what they are offering. So various kits, workshops, Spain, Czech Republic. Oh wow. Let's see if those are active or if they're discontinued. Let's see, Create Tech. It's not in our language, so could not be translated. Create Tech 3D. No, they got an office for a space. Where is that? Granada in Spain.
Yeah, not much for the USA.
So 2014, so there's the Prusa RepRap fan software. I don't know, I can't really tell. It doesn't, let's see, doesn't say anything about the workshops. Let's see, and 220v.biz, Russia. I don't know, not clear, we'd have to track it down. It would be good to, of course, learn from them.
There's a kit from Missouri, 3D printer classifieds.
Where do you see that?
I posted a link in the chat.
Where'd you find that? Just Googled? St. Peter, Missouri, listed
these
in 2014.
Really widespread. Here we have one. Replicio. Let's see where.
3D printer classifieds. So that's just someone selling that for $600. So does the i3 come with a screen?
Not all of them. This one does. I think most people have added the screen now.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's really popular. But the original i3 didn't have a screen. We have...
Okay, so we should specify exactly what kind of version we want, so...
Yeah, here is a kit supplier who's a bit... with a nicer homepage. You can choose frame material, filament diameter, nozzle diameter, and filament type.
Are you going through the list on off the page?
No, I'm just Googling.
Mm-hmm. Wow, $249 for, let's see, is that a full kit?
It says so.
Including electronics? Let's see. It's got a heated bed? Doesn't appear to have the display.
Yeah.
Wow, $249. What? That cheap? I don't think we can beat that. Well, I mean, I don't know. Maybe we can beat it, but we'll have to source the parts ourselves. And that is, let's see, where is that? DHL Worldwide Shipping. Replicio. Let's see where they're located.
Company of fashion people based in Hong Kong and Simon, South China.
Oh wow, that's Hong Kong.
Hong Kong and China.
Interesting, so that's why it's so cheap.
Yeah.
But what's the delivery time? Shipping. Shipping is $80. Total $329.
Yeah, that's really cheap.
Wow. Delivery time 3 to 5 days. Wow.
Fantastic.
It's a little more. It's about $15 more. It's about $94. Wow. Or we can get China Post Airmail for more money. Wow. Okay, this is amazing. That's pretty amazing. It comes down to $345 with the shipping. Oh man. I don't think we can beat that.
No.
Wow. But we should go through the exercise of, right, we should probably take the complete bill of materials and see what it costs part by part if we source it.
Yep.
Wow, but that, man, that is so attractive though. We can... That's amazing. So, filament is $14.99. Let's see what that looks like. ABS, PVA, PLA. Do you know much about polycarbonate 3D printing? It says the Prusa i3 can do it. No, no, the Lulzbot can do it. I don't know. Prusa i3, can it do it?
It depends only on the hot end. It could depend on the extruder as well, but the Prusa i3 has a direct extruder, and that's the best, the most versatile for different materials. So if Lulzbot can do it, then Prusa i3 can do it with the right hot end.
Let's see which hot end this one comes with. Can we figure that out?
I'm trying. Oh, it uses a cheap hot end.
No. Oh.
Not
the...
not a good hot end. It will work for PLA just fine. But one won't work for HTDP, or what they call it, materials that require higher temperatures than 240.
Can you send a link to that?
To the hot end?
Yeah.
Let's see, it's called...
Well, the one you said, the one that you said doesn't... The one from Replicio?
Yeah, they use J-head. The RepRap wiki page. It uses the kind of plastic inside to guide the filament.
Mm-hmm.
And that plastic melts at 240 degrees.
Okay.
What's that plastic called? PTFE.
Okay. So...
But it's an open source hotend.
Yeah.
So that's good.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. GPL.
Nice. So it's not the highest end one, but it does have the open source.
Yeah. Everybody used the PTFE liner before. And then somebody got the idea to use stainless steel for everything. And it worked very well, so new standard is stainless steel.
Yeah. So our protocol should be, let's find five good sources and choose the cheapest one, and then go to sourcing individual parts, where for each part we also do something like five sources to make sure that we're getting the best price on something. And then we, as we look at those parts, we try to create library files in FreeCAD. So I'm going to write that down, process.
I'm looking at their bill of materials, and they say full metal J-head. Never heard of that, but they say it's full metal.
Okay, but hold on a second. When you say J-head, show me the link on the... the Replicio that says it's using J-head. So is the Prusa i3 the undisputed best open source kit?
It's not undisputed because there's so many kits, but it's the most popular one.
Most popular in terms of number of items that are... number of machines that have been built, right?
Yeah. And also number of remixes, remix designs based on the Prusa i3.
Yeah. Let's see, where do you see the... oh yes, more info, extra. Wait, where do you see J-head?
Bottom of the bill of materials wiki page.
No, but on the Replicio site.
If you look at the picture of all the parts, the J-head is the down right corner.
Bottom right corner?
Right.
I see.
The J-head.
I see, you recognize that. Have you worked with that? You've seen that before?
Yeah. Yeah, they work just fine.
Note, all research, this is RepRap site, all research and development on J-head hot ends has stopped due to availability of cheap Chinese counterfeits that have been spammed throughout the online markets, don't work well, and have no support.
Yeah. So if the J-head is a clone made by someone unfamiliar with 3D printing, then it won't work very well. J-head's creator had his own web shop with high quality J-heads that worked very well.
Sorry, who had that?
The creator of the J-head. One of the designers.
And they're not.
Hotends.com. Let's see if they still exist. Hotends.com. One J-head is $57.
Okay, let's document that so that we're aware of this issue, because this is exactly, these kinds of issues are the things we're going to have to work out. Once again, the sourcing. Yeah. So sourcing.
You know, the design is free and open, so it's not hard to make a copy.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
Working really well.
Okay, hold on just a sec here. Sorry, so does that website still exist then? So you said like $67?
Yeah.
See. Does that BOM look like it's complete? Does that parts list look complete?
Yeah.
Where are the connectors? Power supply, stepper motor, heat bed, like the wires. Is that included in electronics?
The wires for the motors?
Everything. Wires for, from the controller to the motors, everything. Cable ties, black cable.
Red and black cable.
Thermistor spiral tubing. And the ends, you solder them on?
No, I'm not sure. Let's look at the picture.
But that's good. They got a Replicio wiki. Media wiki.
Yep.
They're using open standards.
Yeah. Looks like all cables have connectors. Maybe some of them don't. Most of the cables have connectors. I found a blog written by a guy who bought from Replicio, so we can walk through the build process of this.
Nice.
I put it on the Prusa i3 development wiki page.
Okay. Is the J-head well documented in terms of the tricks that make it work well, or that's pretty much a subtle art, or that's very well known?
What do you mean, the tricks that make it work well? You mean...
Well, like why these guys, the Chinese guys, can't replicate it properly, right?
Okay, that's well known and documented.
So why do you think the Chinese guys can't get it right?
Because they want to make manufacturing cheaper, and they don't know what parts of the design are important.
I see.
And where you can make shortcuts.
Okay, so one of the first things to do would be to see whether the counterfeits are suitable. Did this one say that the hot end from Replicio just worked?
I haven't read it. I don't know.
Oh, so... Let's see, what's the shipping information for the hotends.com? International, shipped from the US, typically shipped within 48 hours. So it looks like the shipping would be relatively benign, and if not, we should make contact with, if needed, to make sure that we can special order by express delivery. Let's see what it says for shipping time. And which orifice do we want? 0.4, 0.35, 0.5?
In the nozzle?
Yeah.
I'm not sure. They're all good for different models.
Mm-hmm.
I typically mount one nozzle and then I just keep it forever. And I have different printers. For different sizes of prints.
Mm-hmm.
0.4 is quite standard. It's what most kits ship with, just because it's fairly high detail, fairly quick.
thinking we might want to try the 0.35 for our polycarbonate. Does that make any much of a difference? Does it actually get a thinner print?
Yeah, your printer gets much slower and can print much finer detail if you have 0.35, for example.
Wait a second. 0.5. That setting would have to be set within the settings of the Cura. Say a little about Cura.
Yeah, you will have to specify it in your slicer, yes.
Okay. So that change will be actually a change in a slicing pattern?
Yeah.
So it doesn't... It doesn't just run the same path, it actually changes the slicing?
Yeah, because you get much more narrow lines of plastic extruded.
Yeah, so for example, if we're printing the... Because I was thinking the single strand layer for the polycarbonate glazing, then that means that someone will have to have the same nozzle as well to have the same quality print, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And a file, let's see, and if someone has a different print head, like a fatter one, then what happens if the file is designed for thinner than what, say, 0.5 can print? Does that get you an error in printing, or it just prints it nonetheless?
It will print 0.5 walls. Depending on the slicer decides if this wall is going to be printed or if we just skip it altogether. But you can't print more narrow than 0.5 with a 0.5 nozzle.
Right.
So that's the detail you can get.
If it decides to skip it, what's a typical algorithm for deciding to skip it? If a feature is smaller, simply when
all the details mm-hmm. will be different for different slicers.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, so that's the J head sourcing. Yeah, so that's in stock. And what else? Add to cart to your shopping cart, okay.
Online store.com.
I haven't used it or heard of it, yeah. Asking if
Wow, they give you a better hotend, but it looks like it's E3D.
Let's see what it says for the hotends.com. So that's another source of the hot end? No, you said wrong one.
Yeah.
Yeah, so they have a flat shipping rate, so we'd have to contact hotends.com. What's the guy's name, do you know? Okay. Right, so we'd have to contact them regarding shipping. It's just got one flat shipping rate. They say they... They say they ship within 48 hours, typically.
Yeah. lines or... It gives me a sketchy feeling that they sell the GEE Tech version.
Full acrylic wrap Prusa i3 kit. Do you know of that? Oh, interesting. You think it sounds really sketchy?
This kit itself looks fair enough, but the 3D printers onlinestore.com site. It's sketchy. I don't know what it is. It seems like they supply five or lots of different Prusa kits designed by different people.
Wow.
With different design strengths and mistakes. I don't understand 3DPrintersOnlineStore.com's role in this.
You mean the...
Exactly. So we're just a supplier of other people's kits. Some of the kits they supply are really bad.
The other one that we specified, well, the one from China, let's see, did that one come with the LCD?
The first we looked at?
Yeah.
That was without LCD.
Without. So this one is for the same price, with LCD, with E3D, right?
Yeah.
Which appears to be a little better. But let's see, you're seeing different... Why do you say it's different? It's the Sun Hoki, but
yeah.
What's... Yeah.
Of course, at the bottom you see lots of other kits. Called He3D Prusa i3, G-Tech Premium Prusa i3, EQ Estus Prusa i3, so they have six versions of Prusa i3. Kids.
Wait, I'm going to the Sun Hoki. There's at the very end, it's got the box and EBO certificate of compliance. Are you on that page? And then
yeah.
At the end, it says related products 13. Where are the six other ones you're talking about? Yeah, but that would be right. I mean that. Let's see. When you click on those. Oh, I see. I see. Well, but what's the controversy? It's a 3D printer online store, right? So they sell a bunch of different printers.
Different design
Yeah.
mistakes. So the store itself doesn't seem to know anything about 3D printing because then they would kick out a lot of these bad kids and just
Right.
keep the good ones.
Right.
So we have to be.
Okay, maybe it would be very useful for you to point those to document that right now. So maybe let's can we maybe share your screen and you can point out the mistakes so that that's documented. Yeah, let's try that. That'll be useful.
Share entire screen.
Okay.
Okay, you see my
Yep.
screen?
Yep. So under related products in the last link, we start with
Yeah.
Sunhoki. Does that have errors?
The first thing I look for is the Z screws. If they're put into like fixed in the end, then the lead screw won't be straight, and it will push the entire frame back and forth when it rotates. So what we see here is good. They leave it loose in the end. That means they know you're not supposed to fix it.
How do you see that it's loose in the end? It goes into the receptacle there. It's loose, it's not a tight connection.
It looks loose. Let's see if we get a better picture. Doesn't look like it's going into the frame.
What is it doing? It's into a goes into a hole that is a little larger diameter.
It doesn't go into a hole at all, I think. It
Oh,
stops
it's
before.
loose. Oh, it stops before there. Can you zoom in on that again? Yeah.
There.
Oh, okay. It doesn't reach it. Okay. Good.
So that's good. And we see the metal hot end.
E3D.
I'm not sure which manufacturer. The cooling of the hot end seems a bit sketchy, maybe. Let's see. The entire metal flanged part should be cooled. The
It
cooling
looks like they're
loops.
cooling the wrong thing. Yeah.
Let's see here. Yeah, they need to cool the cooling rivets, all of them.
Looks like they are, right?
Yeah, it looks better here, but this.
That's a different picture than the other one.
Yeah. The. Oh, what's it called? Just have to Google.
Yeah. What's the best way to.
The fan they use there. That's a radial fan.
Oh,
Not
radial fans. So
the
yeah,
coil.
that's nonsense. Yeah, they're not wait, unless that fan also is open at the back. So it actually does cool all the fins.
It's airflow, it's vertical
Yeah.
only.
Yeah, so that's not a great design, is it?
No, it doesn't seem like they've thought about cooling the hot end, and they really should. otherwise you will have disaster. So I'm a bit unsure if this is a good kit, maybe. Another thing to look for is the lead screws. Here they use proper lead screws, and that's good. If they use threaded rods, that's okay. It's not a big problem, but lead screws are better.
Given that there's going to be so many of these that are available probably all over the world, what's our best strategy? I mean, maybe we should look at, since this is what you Googled, what's the verdict on the list from the RepRap project? Should we maybe start with, let's see, has that been refactored and upgraded and so forth,
probably,
or is it
not?
Right, so how do we get the, yeah, I mean, to decide on a best kit, that's going to be quite a trick. We need to...
I found a detail that should be mentioned about this kit.